We're going to meet the sisters who run the hottest new wine bar in the North End. And if you love pizza, you have got
to
stay tuned.
Now, I know a few things about working with my family members, but my next guests are a couple of sisters who run the hottest new dining destination in the North End. From Nebo, Carla and Christina Pallotta. Thank you guys for coming in.
Thank you for having us.
And congratulations on Nebo. The place is cool and it is hot. And I got to ask you about this because now you are a couple of sisters that owned a beauty salon for years. You ran this place very successfully. One day, you decide to say, you know what? We're going to run a restaurant. Why did you possibly decide to do this? And are you crazy? That must be what people ask you.
We are crazy. But because my mom's cooking was this style of food that we eat every night. And for the winter, she goes away. Yep. And for 3 months, we dine out every night. And after a while, you just want your mother's cooking again.
Right.
So I looked at Carla across the table and said to her, I'm opening a restaurant with mom's food. And she's like, yeah, right. And I said, no, I am. You have 3 months and I'm going to do it. You're coming or you're staying. She's like, I guess I'm coming with you. And that was it.
And I can't believe you actually got on board with a crazy idea like this. So it's like food like your mom would make. But the atmosphere is what really kind of strikes me, because that doesn't seem like, you know, an old Italian mama. This is modern and cool. I mean, what's the design like? How'd you guys make this place?
Actually, it's what we think of when we think of Italy.
Yeah.
It's not old world Italian. It's what you'd see in Milan or what you'd see in Rome.
Mm-hmm.
What we'd see actually in New York City. You know, typically the North End has old style Italian restaurants.
Yep.
When we planned this restaurant, we didn't think we were going to end up in the North End. We were just planning to go someplace in the city and ended up back in the neighborhood that we grew up in.
Huh. And so now the name of the place is Nebo, but you call it an Inateca. So what does that word mean, and what does that mean to the style of food you do?
First of all, Nebo stands for North End Boston.
North End Boston, cool name.
Where we grew up.
All right.
And an Inateca is typical of Italian wine bar.
Yeah.
And in Italy, most of the large meals are eaten during the day, and at nighttime, you'd go to an Inateca. We offer 150 Italian wines. We serve wine by the Quartino, which is 1 1/3 glass, and we encourage sharing. And what people would do is get small tastings and mix and match the antipastos. You would share with your friend your little bit of wine, a little bit of the sausages. We have tripe, polenta with shrimp scampi on it, and it's more of a tasting.
It is.
Almost like a tapas in Spain.
Right, and as you guys know, talk about a tasting, because I've been here a few times. Talk about tasting. Have I not gone to town on every single thing?
Well, that hit it all, especially my arancini.
Especially the arancini. We'll get to that in a sec, but it starts with the pizza for me, because the pizzas are just absolutely fantastic. They're thin, they're crispy, and you have a very wide variety, and they're sort of very creative. Tell me about your pizzas. What kind of stuff you guys have?
We actually have 15 gourmet toppings that we sat around one night with a bottle of wine and just got very creative. If you notice right over here, we have a sausage and corn pizza that is my number one seller right now.
Now, it would be typical for you to say that because, of course, what's the name of this pizza?
Oh, that's a Christina.
Right, and your name, of course, is Christina, so this is the most popular
Absolutely.
Pizza.
Absolutely.
It's a flavor explosion. You wouldn't even expect it. Corn
Everyone's
and sausage.
Everyone's shocked by the combination.
And it's unbelievable.
Yes.
But as you said, Carla, I want to get back to what I dream about and my wife dreams about, your arancini. Your arancinis are unbelievable. They're delicious. Now, what's the recipe? Can you tell me the recipe? Can you give me the secret?
Yeah. Arancinis are made in very different ways all over Italy.
Yep.
Excuse me. You're not giving the secret.
Give me everything except the secret.
Yeah.
Describe it without the secret.
In all different parts of Italy, they're made in different ways. Some have meat sauce with peas in it.
Yep.
Some are just plain with nothing stuffed in the middle. Ours are porcini mushroom, arborio rice arancini with a mozzarella cheese inside, drizzled with chestnut honey.
Unbelievable. I mean, also, because it's drizzled in that honey, you get there's just this beautiful glaze, and it's sweet and it's savory all at the same time. They're unbelievable.
Thank
now,
you.
I have to ask you, because I know I work with my brothers, and they absolutely drive me out of my mind, and yet it's still kind of fun. What is it like to kind of have a restaurant? Oh, that is so sweet. No, seriously, do you guys love each other, hate each other in the restaurant? What's it like?
Love each other.
No, we really do.
We actually had one fight, argument, if you want to call it, during the process of this whole restaurant.
About what?
And the size of an oil dish.
The size of an oil dish?
How
you fought
it?
Over the size of an oil dish.
Exactly.
And that was it.
The whole build-out, there was no discrepancy about anything we were doing. We knew what we wanted for style. We knew exactly what we were aiming for, the concept, and went with it.
Who won the oil dish competition?
We actually got somebody to
Halfway?
Make the decision.
All right. Hey, thank you guys very much for coming in.
Thank
Carla
you.
Christina Pallotta. Check out Nebo on the North End, everybody. It's cool and it's delicious. For more information on any of the restaurants featured on today's show, log on to phantomgourmet.com. Sign up for the fan club to receive our weekly email newsletter. Plus, you'll be entered to win Dunkin' Donuts gift checks. And this is Dan Andelman asking, if you visit a restaurant seen on this show, tell them the Phantom sent you. And reminding anyone who operates a restaurant, you gotta treat every customer like a critic. You never know which one could be the Phantom Gourmet.